Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a closer look at application shortcuts in the dock. So probably the most common misconception about the dock is that the applications actually are in the dock. And that's not true. These are actually just shortcuts or aliases to the location of the applications. Where are the applications? Well, if you go into the Finder, you look in your Applications folder, you'll find all of your applications, or nearly all of them. And this is actually where the files are on your hard drive. So, for instance, if we want to look at the Photos app, there it is inside the Applications folder. And I could double click that to run the Photos app. The Photos app is also shown down here. This is a shortcut. When I tap this one, when I click it, I'm actually just doing a shortcut to run the application which is located here. Now this is important because if you were to take this, drag it up and out, it would disappear from the dock. And a lot of people wrongly identify this as deleting their app or getting rid of the app. The app is now lost. It's not. In fact, it's still here in applications. Notice it didn't move at all here. Just your shortcut to it is no longer there. People commonly do exactly what I just did to remove a shortcut from the dock for an app that they don't use very often, so they don't need easy access to. Now if you do that by accident, it's very easy to put back. Just go into your Applications folder and drag back in. Now the application is still there in the Applications folder. You've just added a shortcut to it in the dock. And this way you can actually add more apps here. So if there's an app that does not appear here, maybe something you've installed, you can drag it from the Applications folder and put it in the dock where you want it to. And likewise you can remove it by dragging it up and releasing it near the top of the screen. Another thing people don't understand about the dock all the time is what happens when you run an app that's not in the dock. So I'm going to run Preview and notice how it was added to the right side of the dock. So it appears to be here now in the dock. But if I were to quit this app, because it's not in the dock normally, it disappears from the dock. So the dock shows you all the apps you've permanently put in there as shortcuts, and it also shows you any other apps that are currently running. If I were to want to put this app permanently in the dock, I could drag it from here into here. I could also drag it while it's in the dock and move it just some amount to the left. Anywhere I put it here, it's going to tell the dock that I don't want this to go away when I quit. So I'm going to quit Preview now, and you can see that it remains there in the dock. Notice also that it was very easy for me to rearrange what's here just by dragging it around. The dock can also be used to drag and drop things. So for instance, I have a file here on my desktop. If I were to grab that file, click and drag it, and move it over the items here in the dock, only the ones that can accept this type of file will be shown. So for instance, Preview, it will show Preview above there and you can see that it's active, whereas Notes and Calendar won't accept this type of file. If I were to release over Preview, it opens up the file in that app. So it's very easy to actually, instead of opening the file then choosing File, Open, and grabbing the document, to just drag and drop in order to do that. Now you can also do more with the icons that are down here rather than just launch the app or drag something onto them. If you control click, or if you're using a trackpad you can usually do a two finger click. I'm going to use control click here on any of these apps. You get a lot of options and it will depend what the app does as to which options you get. For Preview I get recently opened documents. I get the currently open document here, and if there were more than one I could select which one and it would bring that window to the front. I've got some options including Show in Finder, so I can find out where that app is currently located. And I've got the ability to do things like hide or even quit the app from this menu here. So you can do a lot with these. Notice that some of these other apps have different things that you can do, and it really depends on what it is. Here in the Finder, for instance, you can do all sorts of things like new Finder window, new smart folder, all right from control clicking on the dock shortcut.